Formula One has had some amazing stories over the past few weeks. We've also seen some intense things going down on the course. Today, we'll be covering how the FIA insists Red Bull was warned over Perez's Monza F1 penalty and some other Formula One news. You won't want to miss this list, so stay tuned for more. First up is, what was the penalty that Perez was given? Before we get into anything regarding what went down after the penalty, we should go over just what happened in order for Perez to receive one in the first place. During the recent race, Perez was given a 5-second penalty on the Monza track. This made him fall from 3rd place to 5th place. It seems like he was given this penalty because he was seen to cut a corner. This was deemed unfair and easily gave him an advantage over the other drivers on the track. It was clear that he went off of the track. They seemingly had no contact from the teams to let them know it was something penalty worth. This means they kept on going without actually realizing what happened. What did his team say about the penalty? To say the least, his teams weren't exactly happy about the whole thing. The team boss, Christian Horner, went on to talk about the penalty after the race was over. He said, "That was tough because we were expecting a call from the stewards to say if they weren't happy with it, then give it back." Of course, the call didn't come. Then when eventually the penalty comes up, the gaps aren't opening up, so that was tough for him. He drove a good race today and 3rd on the road, 5th overall, was a frustrating result. It's safe to say that we aren't happy with what went down, but are glad he didn't get pushed all the way down the list. Even though he went from 3rd to 5th, he still had a great race that day. FIA insists Red Bull was warned about the penalty. Even though from the main team of Red Bull, everyone was told that the FIA didn't contact them about the penalty, it seems like they actually did. The race director of Formula One, Michael Masi, stated that he did in fact speak to the pit wall of the Red Bull team. Michael Masi is in contact with all of the teams who race on a track and is able to discuss whatever he needs to with them. There's no doubt he had the means to contact Red Bull, and according to him, he actually did. Masi told interviewers that he told the team about the penalty, but Red Bull responded saying they were looking into themselves. And this is an awkward situation, but one that can easily be solved. What is the FIA about? So, what exactly are the FIA about, and what do they intend to do on the course of each race? The director himself, Michael Masi, has stated on multiple occasions that the FIA are there to check and ensure that any advantage gained by running off track was handed back in full, and that it would not accept drivers trying to game the system. This is the need of the FIA in this situation, and it obviously does more. This is the most relevant part of their system for this penalty, and it makes a whole lot of sense why they would be involved. What else had been going on with Perez? The surprising thing about this entire thing was that Perez was fresh off another incident the day before this actually occurred. Before the day of the race, Perez was actually being investigated for possibly delaying handing over a place to Lance Stroll in the sprint race. This actually ended up dropping Lance Stroll out of the DRS train. It wasn't a good few days for Perez, and it's not looking good for his future right now. Whilst F1 drivers are known to have some controversy every now and then, this one seems to come down to his team instead of him. The communication clearly wasn't there, and it's their entire job to relay information to their driver. Maybe we'll see Perez move teams in the near future. 2022 Formula One drivers. Who's going where? The teams are set to switch up for the next season of Formula One, but just who's going where and who's staying around? Mercedes confirmed that Lewis Hamilton will be staying with them and that George Russell will finally be joining their team after long speculation. Red Bull have confirmed that Max Verstappen is staying with them due to his long contract and that Sergio Perez is staying after his contract was extended into 2022. McLaren have said that Lando Norris will be staying after signing a multi-year contract extension with them and that Daniel Ricciardo will be staying until the 2023 season. Aston Martin have stated that both Sebastian Vettel and Lance Stroll will be staying with them. And finally, Ferrari will be keeping both Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz Jr. for a while longer. Obviously, there are more teams in the sport, but these are the main ones people want to know about. McLaren COO Jonathan Neal is leaving after 20 years. After more than 2 decades, COO of McLaren, Jonathan Neal will be leaving the company. He joined McLaren all the way back in 2011 as the operations director and then moved up towards the team's manager back in 2005. He's played a big role in the evolution of the team and made it that much stronger before they helped Lewis Hamilton win his first world championship all the way back in 2008. We don't know the exact date that he'll be stepping down from his role, but it's most likely going to be at the end of the latest season. He will be missed in the F1 world. Albon doesn't know what his very strict clauses will be over his contract. Alex Albon is one of the newest drivers to join one of the biggest teams in Formula One, Mercedes. He's been given a contract for his time there, but recently came out and said that he doesn't really know the very strict clauses around it that are set to protect Mercedes. He's going to race for their Williams team next year with Nicholas Latifi by his side in the race. His clause seems to be based around the engine they're using for his car. Everything is really top secret, so he needs to keep his mouth shut, or he'll easily lose his job. Kubica knows that there are drivers higher up the list than him for a new F1 seat. Robert Kubica is known for winning the Grand Prix once and has seen to make two appearances under the team Alfa Romeo in the past. Alfa Romeo has an open seat for the 2022 season, and he has his eyes on it. He is in the running with around even other drivers from across the landscape. The driver who's picked will drive alongside Valtteri Bottas on the track. Sadly, Robert Kubica has some tough competition, and recently he stated that he knows there are more and better drivers high up the list than he is for his seat in Alfa Romeo. Hopefully he gets the seat he wants, but he won't be disappointed if he doesn't get it. He already knows it's a low possibility for him. And that's the end of the list. This recent F1 race and stories around it have made some amazing headlines and some great strides in the industry of Formula One. We now know some things about the future of the sport as well. The next season of the sport is looking bigger and better than ever. Some heavy hitters are being moved around and some are staying where they have for the past few years now. This sport is looking in really good shape for the next season, and with the inclusion of newer engines, this season should be really good to watch. The other major thing we covered was the penalty for Perez in the latest Formula One race. Isn't really looking good for Red Bull in that whole situation, as they clearly didn't communicate enough with each other and the sources they really need to keep an eye on. We know that these races are tough to keep track of, and they really want the best for their drivers, but something like this just doesn't sit right with anyone. Everyone knows that Perez went off the course and gave himself a huge advantage over the others. It was just the fact that Red Bull claimed they were not informed of any penalties. Maybe Red Bull will do some sorting out after this season is over and get ready for the next season ahead. This next Formula One season could be one of the biggest yet. There are so many changes going behind the scenes with players and the cars themselves. We should be in for an amazing season coming up in 2022. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe with notifications on. Thanks for watching.